students, welcome to your English grammar class. Today we are going to start with this new chapter, present perfect tense. Okay, so what is present perfect tense? Present perfect tense denotes an action that stands in the past and completed before the present time. Means it is started in the past and it is completed before the present time. So that is present perfect tense. Now we'll see its uses. Okay, where is it used? To describe an action of which the time is not known. Okay, when the time of the action is not known, the students have completed their homework. Means here in this sentence, you don't know when exactly they completed their homework. The flight has already taken off. So here also there is no specific time mentioned, but it seems that the action is completed. Then to express an action of which the effects will be on present time. Okay, the action will be done and the effect will be seen on the present time. The athlete has lost his shoes. Rahul has eaten his food. To show an action that started in the past and is continuing till the time of speaking. Like for example, my father has known his friends for a long time. Brinda has lived at her granny's home since childhood. So action started in the past and is continuing till the time of speaking. Now let's move on to the sentence structure for the present perfect tense. First we'll be seeing the affirmative sentence, that is a positive sentence, and its sentence structure. So first, subject plus have, has plus verb in the third form and other words. Again, with he, she, we use has, and I, we, you, they, we use have. This remains the same for all, right? And verb in the third form plus other words. Let's see the exercise A. Complete the following sentence using present perfect tense from the verbs given in the brackets. These are the verbs given in the brackets. You have to change it into present perfect tense. Okay. So, somebody dashed the jewelry of Mrs. Nanda. Okay. So, here, what is the subject? Somebody is the subject over here. And then, what do you need to do? We need to add have and has, right? So, we'll be adding has over here. And steal, third form of the verb steal is stolen. So somebody has stolen the jewelry of Mrs. Nanda. Vishaka dash Vishal since childhood. So again, Vishaka, what we need to add? We need to add something before the verb, in between the verb and the subject, right? So here Vishaka is the subject and know is the verb. So we need to convert this into the third form. So we'll make it into known and has. Vishaka has completed, Vishaka has known Vishal since childhood. The remaining ones you can try doing on your own. See the second type of the sentence, that is negative sentence, and we'll be viewing its sentence structure. Again, everything remains the same. You just need to add not to insert negation in this sentence. So subject plus have, has plus not, and verb in the third form plus other words. So where you will be adding not over here, please make sure you don't make any you cannot add it after the subject or after the verb. You need to add it between the helping verb and the third form of the verb. This is the helping verb, right? And this is the third form of the verb. So the not comes in between the helping verb and third form of the verb to make it into a negative sentence. Again, with I, we, you, they, we use have, and with he, she, we use has. See the second exercise. Change the following sentences into negative form. Okay, so this sentence particularly we have to change it into negative sentence form. Our neighbors have left for their picnic. Okay, so which is the subject? Our neighbors. Again, helping verb have. Left is the verb, right? Third form of the verb. And for their picnic, these are the other words. So where you need to insert have or has over here? Yes, between the subject and the third form of verb. Between the helping verb and the third form of verb. So it will be right here, right? So our neighbors have not left for their picnic. You can try doing the remaining ones on your own. So students, for your task for today is to revise this and complete exercise A and B. And I'll also be sharing a video for the explanation part of this chapter in detail. If you all have any doubts, you all can contact me. Thank you.